Jimmy, that was a pretty good second half performance, in particular, wasn't it? 3-0 at home to Kendal, you can't really knock that.
No, I was beginning to think they're a bit of a bogey side. You know, we beat them in the FA Cup here, but the two games we played up there in the trophy and the league, they beat us, and you have to say they beat us well. So, you know, the pleasing thing for me is that we had seven players on the 21 at the start of the game, and that's fantastic, that experience that they're gaining, and particularly when you win a game, will certainly hold us in good stead.
That's it, we've been looking for that transition as a club now, you know, trying to, at the end of the season, bring players through, and the young lads are really showing that they can do it, aren't they, some of them?
Yes, they are, and it's important to, you know, you need a certain amount of experience to do well in any league, but it's important that you bring your young players through, and, you know, it all bodes well for all our junior teams, that they can see these lads that are 18, 19 in the first team, and you know, if they work hard enough at the game, they've got a chance maybe coming through.
Our man of the match today on the radio was Casper. We thought he was outstanding. He really shows what he's got. I mean, he's on loan from Crewe. He's so technically brilliant, isn't he?
He is, yeah. I've known Casper since he was a baby, more or less, and he's always been a terrific little footballer. And, you know, it's a tough old league we're playing in. And he you know, last week against Northwich, it was a learning curve for him because they got about him a little bit. And he perhaps didn't have the best of games, but at home, there's not a problem playing him. As you say, he's technically gifted. He sees a pass and he can twist and turn and create space for himself. And I thought he had an excellent game tonight.
And looking ahead towards the end of the season now, is it just a case of trying to get as many points on the board and giving these young lads a go, etc.?
Yeah, it is. I mean, they've been having a go the last few weeks. And you know, you're not going to win every game with young lads because of that perhaps lack of... You know, we lost to Northwich last week, and it was probably that they had an extra bit of experience that we probably needed. And it happened again at the workshop at home, I remember, was one of the games. So you're not going to win every game with them, but the experience that they're gaining is valuable for them as you know, developing players.
Cheers, Jimmy. Thanks. Cheers, Casper, great win for the team, that one, it 3-0 at home.
Yeah, it's a much needed win for the team, like confidence and stuff like that, so hopefully we'll take that into the next game.
You played well yourself, you got man of the match on the radio, we were really impressed with yourself. You looked to, you know, pass the ball really well. Are you getting confident as a player now, you're getting a run of games?
Yeah, it's a big pitch as well, what helps, more space and time on the ball, but other than that, it's my first man of the match, so I'm happy with that.
And you said to us, 4th of April, you go back. Have you enjoyed your spell here so far? Obviously, there's a little bit to go yet. Has it helped you as a player, do you think?
Oh, yeah. Loads. I'm getting game time, which I needed, and I've enjoyed it at Nantwich, and I was on loan last year, so I'm happy to be back here on loan. So.
What's the future hold for Casper Hughes then at Crewe when you go back? What are you expecting?
Well, it's up to them. It's up to them. I couldn't tell you. I don't know what they want, like what I'm looking for and stuff.
Are you confident, though? You think you're doing well enough?
Yeah, I've been doing well for myself, so it's just it's in their hands at the moment. But if like today, I've done myself proud, so it's up to them.
Yeah, cheers, Casper. Thanks.